Motherfucker.
This first story, there are a group of individuals who, for reasons that they do not know and do not understand, do not die, and have moved through the centuries, becoming the most dangerous soldiers you can ever imagine.
We're all here because of Greg. He wrote an incredible story in this graphic novel. It's really my Bible, both in story but also in tone.
For the comic, it really was always meant to be Andy's journey. And when it came time to adapt it, it forced me to do a lot of character work on Nile, on Nikki, on Joe, on Booker. There needs to be an equal amount of meat on everybody's bone.
No, not another one.
I think it was crucial to keep Andy's essence, the essence of the person who's so tired from living so many lives, the emotional exhaustion of losing so many people who she's loved. Those were the things that I wanted to always kind of be the foundation of Andy, and then have that foundation slowly crumble when the character of Nile shows up in her life.
I think one of the biggest things we did was really elevate the character of Nile and really give her some more agency.
Nile is the baby. Nile is the new one. She's a Marine who was deployed to Afghanistan.
She just found out she can't die. It's difficult for her to understand what is happening now. I mean, everything changes. So she's the new blood in this.
Quiet.
I said!
I know what you said. What are you going to do, kill me?
I am really excited to hear what people think when they finally do get to see it, because there are changes. There have to be changes. A comic is not a movie. But the heart and the soul of what the comic was absolutely translates.
I don't suppose it would be possible to get this change, all of us.
The essence, I feel, is the same. They're doing an incredible job, and the crew of actors and the technical team is really impressive.
I'm a big Greg Rucka fan. I think he's incredibly talented, and I don't think we would have been able to make the movie that we ended up making without him.